It's an infinite cycle of bombings. When they are blown up, they come back to life. The two must find the killer to break out of the cycle. After 13 rounds, the most suspicious man is finally subdued, only to discover that the killer is not him at all, but it also accidentally saves him. Jack sees what they're up to, so he takes them to his secret base. He discovers that the two men are something else. Mike didn't want to explain, because no one believes they've entered the cycle. But what he didn't expect was, Jack listened, and not only believed without question, he claimed to be joining them to save the world. So you believe in us? The two men couldn't believe it. They thought, is this guy an idiot? So Jack is a second timer. He believes he's the chosen one of the light saviors. Now that Jack had believed in them, Annie said that in case he did get into the cycle, that would be one more helper. So they began a careful search of the car for suspects. There were now three suspects: the older man with the sack of stuff, the old man with the suitcase, and the aunt with a parcel under her feet. But before they could finish their analysis, Jack's mother called him home for dinner. As they said their goodbyes, Jack said that even if he didn't make it into the loop, he could still be of help, calling on him whenever he was needed. Call out his name, and he would unconditionally choose to believe. It seems that Jack is very sick. Mike takes Annie to an internet cafe to investigate the information. Time was short. They had to do something now. Jack returns home, realizing that he was about to enter a cycle to save the world. So he writes a suicide note to his parents, and put everything that happened today in his diary. He said he was about to find the bomb in the car with Mike and the others, and the police haven't been idle. The police had been investigating the passengers on the bus. The three of them were soon found to be suspicious. Jack was immediately taken to the interrogation room for questioning. To keep the police from suspecting Mike and the others, Jack covered for them. Soon afterwards, Annie and the two of them received a call from the police. Mike didn't want to be investigated, but Annie thought they had a lead on some passengers at the police station. So they went to the police station. They told Team Zhang about all the suspicious people in the car. He was particularly suspicious of the man with the sack. Just as Annie was about to leave, she did get a key clue. He overheard information about the sack boy. He found out that the man was a recently released murderer, and that he didn't have a good relationship with his family. Annie is immediately serious when she hears this. There were signs that this man was a serious suspect. When Jack was finished with the investigation, the police let them go. But just then, Jack's mother arrived.